Lennon Show.
Hello, my name's John Lennon. When they told me I was going to do a radio show on YouTube, they said, John, what you need to have is some bookshelves behind you to make it look smarter, more academic, you know, more middle class. But here's the thing, I'm working class from Liverpool. All of this behind me, it's just a green screen, it's not really there. I can be walking in New York now, look. See, now I'm walking in New York. That's technology these days. But here's what I think about technology. When I was growing up, just after the war, we didn't have any money. We had no penny to look together. You know, it would cost you money to buy a calculator. Even a bat telephone calculator, we couldn't even afford that. You know, half a shilling, that's 25p for a calculator. Couldn't afford that. We had to count up with our fingers. You know, we weren't even allowed calculators at school anyway back then. You know, you'd caned if you used one of them. But anyway, what I'm saying is technology has changed. For the worse. I mean, you've got iPhones now. You've got laptops. You've got iPads. You've got robots that clean your car. You've got robots that wash your clothes. Do your carpet. Do your cooking. That's technology. You know, when I was a teenager, I used to hold my girlfriend's hand. People don't hold hands anymore. They hold mobile phones and iPads and things like that. So if you ask me, technology has become the death of us all, the death of society. Anyway, that's my rant over. Here's a song.
Stanley, doing your Christmas shopping too? Yes, frankly, yes. I'm trying to buy something from Wilkins. Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas. Well, you're on Christmas, Carla. Don't want anything. Don't give me anything. What are you missing, Stanley?
It's a nice day today.
Join us, John Lennon's radio show.
Anyway, what does everyone think about the current state of the world? You know, I'm talking about the wars in Gaza, in Ukraine, and Russia, and all the other things going on. Putin, are we going to have a nuclear war? Here's my thought on it. If there are any sense, they will stop it all, but they don't, do they? They don't have any sense. Putin, he's probably dead anyway. I think he died, and they almost took over. That's why you never see him on telly anymore. Anyway, this is all just control. This has been going on since time immemorial. People trying to control the planet, to control the human race. Nothing's changed, really. So, my idea of having peace on the world, in the world, it's not over, but we're nowhere closer now than we were in the 60s, you know. Anyway, give me a call and let me know your thoughts and I'll ask you questions. Look at this bloody bookcase. Bloody hell.
Join us and call us, John Lennon's radio show.
Call me. Hello, and welcome back. Now, we've got somebody on the phone, so let's speak with him. Who's there?
Yeah, it's Frankie. My name's Frankie.
Hello, Frankie. And what do you have to say?
I just want to say, in World War One, there was a football match on Christmas Day, and they all stopped fighting. What if they did that in Russia, and Ukraine, and Gaza? Would that start peace and stuff.
Well, Frankie, maybe you're right. But here's the thing about Christmas. Christmas time, you know, is for one man, a guy called Jesus Christ, who apparently died for our sins. And I say apparently for the reason that, you know, we can't prove that there was a Jesus. We can't prove there wasn't. We can't prove there was a God. We can't prove there isn't. You know, you just got to believe in what you want to believe in. So Frankie, what I'm saying is, even if they did want to have peace just for one day, for Christmas Day, half of those people don't believe in gods, and half of them do, or another, a different gods, do you know what I mean? So, who knows? But that's an interesting point, Frankie, thank you.
Thanks so much.
Okay, we'll have one more call, and then we'll go to our game. But that's who got down.
Hello, this is Stanley Bones.
Ah, the famous Stanley Bones.
Oh, you've heard of me?
Yeah, I've heard of you, yeah.
Yes, of course you've heard of me. We saved you. Right, that's my question. If we hadn't saved you in 1980, do you think the world would be a different place? What if you had died in 1980?
Would it be any different if I had died in 1980? Here's my answer, Stanley. I don't think anything would be any different. I'm just one man. Whether I'm alive now or I died in 1980, doesn't matter. I mean, you saved me, you and Wilkins, so. But I go back to see Mark Chapman's grave once a year, give him flowers. I know that sounds strange, you know, he's the guy that shot me, or tried to shoot me, he was going to shoot me, but you saved us. But I did it anyway, you know. I mean, that's how you should be, you should forgive. That's the time for forgiving, you know, Christmas time and that. That's how I always do it. But coming back to your original question, no, I don't think anything would be this, would be any different. So there you go.
Good answer, John. Thank
okay.
You.
Now that game, I promised you. So this is a game called What Are You Talking About? We have two pairs. Now one of them has to explain to the other one something about Christmas, and the other one has to guess what he's trying to explain. But the guy explaining cannot mention the word and anything to do with Christmas or anything to do with the thing. So a certain word he's not allowed to say. Basically, another guy has to try and guess what he's saying. So now let's bring out our first pair. You'll understand when we start playing. And we have Kim and Freddie. I hope you guys are listening to the rules there.
Okay.
And Freddie, you can't see the screen. You'll be the one guessing.
All right.
Kim, you need to do this in David Attenborough style.
David Attenborough?
His voice.
All right, you do this, Kim.
The time starts now.
Right. Okay, imagine this is an animal from a farm.
Right.
Imagine a farm animal and...
A cow.
This farm animal... yes, farm animal, yeah.
A cat, yeah.
It's cold. Imagine it's cold and it wants to warm up.
Chicken, frozen chicken.
It would be in bed. What would it...
What are you talking about?
But he would lie under something. What would it lie under if it wanted to warm itself up?
I was in bed, blanket. A pig,
yes.
Pig.
So?
Pigs in blankets.
No.
Pigs in blankets.
Yes, yes, pigs in blankets. Yes, further. And now, this one is, it's like a horse.
Pony.
Imagine weather, you know.
Weather?
It's windy. Not sunny, but it might be something else.
Windy pony.
Add that to an animal that was like a horse with twigs coming out of his head.
Oh, like a... Oh, what's it called?
Sticks
rain,
and stuff.
Reindeer.
Yes. And
reindeer.
Yes. Reindeer, yes.
Yeah, all right.
Okay.
Good.
That's
his
time up.
That hell.
He scored two.
That's tricky.
You got two right.
That's two. Yeah.
Well done.
Because I'm better.
Okay, thanks for that, guys. Cheers.
Well done. Well done,
okay.
Kim.
Okay. Now, let's bring in our second pair, which is the McCafferty's. Okay, Christmas things, there's words you can't say. Okay, but you
right,
got to
John,
do this, kind of, in the voice of Donald Trump.
Donald Trump.
It's going to be funny.
Okay. You're ready, your time starts now.
Right, Connor, this is a guy who can fly, and he wears red.
Superman.
No, it's not Superman. It's not. He does good things.
Santa Claus.
Yes, Connor.
Of course.
It's Santa Claus. Okay, and the next one is okay. Now, if Donald Trump, if I was gonna take a missile to Russia or China,
what?
Then I would, you know, use this
missile
weapon. But I would use my feet. The end of my feet.
What are you talking about?
What would that be called?
The sole of your feet.
What's at the end of your feet, Connor?
Your toes then.
Yes. An attic with the other...
Missile and toe. Mistletoe.
That's it. Mistletoe. Yeah.
Jesus
okay.
Christ.
Now this one. Oh, God. Okay.
Come on.
Now this is like a party with three men and a baby.
Three men and a little baby?
No, film. That's the film, Connor. No.
Yeah.
This it's has no. Something in the sky is moving around. You know, no, you follow
moon.
That.
The moon. The sun.
Not the moon. No.
Stars.
Yes. Okay.
Oh, the what nativity scene.
Yes. The nativity scene. Yeah. Yes.
Okay, right, that's the okay. Time up.
Bloody hell.
Come on, guys. Right. You scored three.
Jesus Christ.
Did we win there? John, did we win?
Yes, they won. The McCafferty's won. They
good
got three.
Job, Connor.
The other guy's got two. So oh, well I'm done. Sorry. Well done. Okay. Well, that was good fun, wasn't it? Right. So, there you go. That's my first episode over. So I'll be back very soon before Christmas. And we'll have another episode. But before I go, here's a little song. Piece to sing on to.
So this is Christmas. And what have you done? Another year over. And you won't just be gone. And so this is Christmas. I hope you had fun. The near and the dear ones, the old and the young.
A very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Great time, we'll see you next time. Goodbye.
And so this is Christmas. For weak and for strong. The rich and the